Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of The World Today. I'm Ahmed Nader, and as usual, we will be discussing the latest headlines and the articles published in several newspapers and magazines from Egypt and the world. And of course, we will be starting straight over from Al Ahram Online with the main headline saying, Egypt paid the price for removing a terrorist group at its strongest, according to President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi implied that unnamed foreign countries are interfering with the Egyptian domestic affairs, speaking 2 days after a series of militant attacks killed at least 30 Egyptians in the Sinai Peninsula on Thursday. The president did not specify which countries he was referring to, but relations with Turkey and Qatar have been strained since the ouster of Mohamed Morsi in 2013. Al-Sisi cut short his visit to Ethiopia, where he was due to attend an African Union summit, after a series of deadly attacks in North Sinai on Thursday claimed scores of lives. Sinai-based militant group Ansar Bayt al-Maqdis, which has pledged allegiance to Daesh group, claimed responsibility for the violence. In his speech, Al-Sisi said that Egypt is paying the price for choosing to end the rule of a terrorist group at its strongest point. Al-Sisi said that the Brotherhood has been planning, widening their horizons and establishing a stronghold all over the world, and said that combating the group will take a long time as well. He highlighted in his speech that he knew that there would be a wave of terrorism after Mohamed Morsi's ouster. The president declared the bloodshed but emphasized that the army and the police are able to combat terrorism in the country. And I'm honored to be having with me over the phone right now Mr. Mustafa Tamam, the political analyst. Mr. Mustafa, can you hear me? Mr. Mustafa, what would be your first comment regarding the terrorist attacks that hit the Egyptian army and the Egyptian police forces in Sinai on Thursday, and of course the reaction of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi 2 days later?
The reaction and action taken by the president yesterday to affirm someone responsible for the Sinai situation was quite an important measure in order to combat all these attacks, you see, which have focused on the army and on the police and also on civilians. So this is a really important strategy and an important process in order to change the methodology that is going to handle these terrorist actions. Secondly, there will be a plan which will be confidential, which no one will know, in order to handle unexpected situations like the situation of just met since a couple of days ago.
Mr. Mustafa, regarding the security measures that were taken by the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces and President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, how do you see the efficiency of the new military strategy in Sinai, as of course a new military body was formed to combat terrorism in the peninsula?
Definitely, they are quite important measures, because as we know that we have been witnessing a lot of attacks. The number of attacks have decreased, but certainly the tactics have been different. So the point is that in order to meet unexpected situations, these measures were very, very important in order to meet the unexpected events, terrorist events which might occur in the scene nowadays.
Yes, Mr. Mustafa, one more important aspect regarding these attacks on the Egyptian army and the Egyptian police is the reaction of the international human rights groups. How do you see that after the attacks?
Well, I see it very negative here, and it's not appropriate with the incident to say, you see. Let us compare the reaction of what happened in France and the reaction that happened in Egypt here since 2 days ago. It's a very negative attitude. And I don't think it is giving a positive image to this organization. And in Egypt, a very, very important point that this organization is working on double standards, you see. If they didn't even, they said we disapproved and they left. And on the other side, we see that the American Department of State is meeting terrorist organizations, and they are saying that these are We are meeting the people from all political parties. These must represent the political parties. They represent the terrorist organization. This is something extremely serious, and I think we should be having a quite sharp look upon the statements that we issued and the actions that are, and the reports that are issued in this respect.
Yes, Mr. Mustafa, regarding President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and his visit to the African Union Summit, how important was the step of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi to be cutting his visit to Ethiopia and returning home after those attacks?
Definitely, this is a very important move that the President took, because this is a very serious situation. There have been a number, very great number of people who died, and a lot of casualties. And the tactics which the mechanism that the terrorist group used is different than the one we used to every time. So it was very important in order to put a new plan, to put a new strategy, to try to see how we're going to overcome all these actions.
Yes, Mr. Mustafa, turning to the Al-Ahram online with the main headline saying, Egypt appoints a new commander for the Third Army. Defense Minister Sidqi Subhi has appointed on Sunday General Muhammad Abdullah as a new commander of the 3rd Army, replacing Lieutenant General Osama Askar, who was tasked on Saturday by the Supreme Council of the Armed Forces Saturday with leading the new Unified Military Command east of the Suez Canal. The Unified Command will guide counter-terrorism activities the 2nd and the 3rd Armies in the Sinai Peninsula. The 2nd Army oversees North Sinai and some Delta governorates as well. The 3rd Army oversees the army operations in South Sinai and Suez, on the other hand. The creation of the new command comes following the deadly militant attack on Thursday on the security and the army positions in the rest of North Sinai governorate that left at least 30 people dead, including army personnel and civilians. Mr. Mustafa, how could this step help the Egyptian army in combating militant insurgency in the Sinai Peninsula, of course?
Well, the terrorists have changed the tactics and the strategies and the methodologies. Also, the Egyptian army has changed its tactics and has appointed new people and redesigned the structure, the organizational structure of this important department that is going to handle terrorism. So probably it will need new people, new ideas, new thoughts. So this is something normal and we should expect that.
Mr. Mustafa, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi also met on Sunday with representatives of several political parties, saying that 10 billion Egyptian pounds would be allocated to develop the Sinai Peninsula. Do you think that this is possible in the coming months and years?
We are not afraid of terrorism. We are going to invest in Sinai. We are going to do business in Sinai. We are going to invest in Sinai because, as the president said, he said a very important statement, I am ready to die for the cause of Egypt. So everyone, I don't think anyone is going to agree that we are going to leave this issue to the terrorists to go forward. We are going to fight for it, we are going to keep it, as we did in 1973 with the army, as we did in all issues that the Egypt faces. We are going to win at the end because we have the right, and we are on the right track.
Yes, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi also said that it would be a hard, long battle for the army against the militants in Sinai. How much time do you think it would be taking the Egyptian army and the Egyptian police to be uprooting terrorism in the peninsula?
Yes, this is a very big question that we are doing, because now we are not facing a first organization. We are facing the worldwide terrorist organization, which has multi-disciplinary dimensions. We don't know the dimensions, we don't know where all the comes and all the ends. So it's very good. We have changed, we have to be careful, we have to give our trust to the army, we have to support the people of Egypt, really Mr. Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, all of the governments and everyone, because this is not a danger only to the president and to the army. It's a danger to the whole of Egypt. We want to destroy Egypt, and that's their objective.
Yes, Mr. Mustafa, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi also said that the economic summit will be held in the month of March here in Egypt in the Red Sea Resort city of Sharm el-Sheikh, as I said, in the month of March. How important is it for President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi to be stressing that the conference will be held on time?
This flight changes flags after the red attack on the terrorist attack in last 15 days. I don't think anything will change. We're going to change this our plan and we're going to do our homework properly. And the country is going to improve and go ahead if we fall flag to Taiwan.
Yes, another part of the equation is the help of the Arab brothers, the United Arab Emirates, Bahrain and Kuwait. Prime Minister Ibrahim Ahmed has talked with the Kuwaiti Emir, Sheikh Al-Jaber Al-Sabah in Kuwait on Sunday, as the Emir stressed that he will be participating in the economic conference. So how important is it for Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Kuwait, Bahrain and many other Gulf countries to be standing by Egypt in this critical phase?
Well, actually, all, you see, it's not only the Gulf space, it's all the region is in danger. So if we don't all of us cooperate, I am afraid that all the region is going to be into trouble.
Mr. Mustafa, turning to the Independent and the UK pledge of support for the Egyptian fight against terrorist elements. The British government condemned the series of military attacks in Sinai, pledging to stand with in the fight against terrorist violence. The British Foreign Secretary said the UK stands with the Egyptian government and people in the fight against terrorist violence. The UK has been playing a leading role in the American National Coalition of over 60 countries.